What do you think? Good. Good morning, everybody. It is Saturday morning. I think it's either March 1st or 2nd. I'm gonna guess March 2nd. Saturday, March 2nd. And we gotta run some errands today. And we're just going to get this day started. It's about 10 a.m. or so. And we are going to meet up with one of my friends at my storage locker. So he is driving over an hour to get there. And he's I've met him in person before. He's a nice, cool dude. And his name is Nick. And
Yo, Nick,
what's up, buddy? He's gonna buy the last of my Audi stuff. So he's the guy that I gave all of my lesser expensive Audi parts and stuff to last year, I think it was. And I told him, you know, I still have more stuff. I just told him that if he wants it, he's going to have to buy it off of me. So it's all my stage 3 parts, my TCU, my ECUs, my all my tools, my custom, or not custom, but my like special Audi tools or Euro tools, I guess you could call them. And yeah, so it's gonna be a good day today. Nikki's coming out too a little bit later, just after lunchtime. And we're gonna try to get this old truck, cleaned and detailed today. So we'll see if we can make that happen. I don't know if we're gonna have enough time or whatnot, but I need gas, need to get it washed and cleaned on the inside and out. And I don't know what else, but before I return it back to my dad, Grandma and Grandpa are coming back tomorrow. We're excited about that. They're driving back from Arizona and takes them a few days or so. They left Friday. We'll be back Sunday afternoon or evening. I don't know what else is going on. That's it. That's all I got. We went to the vet yesterday for Sophie. And, you know, I told them, like, kind of like some of the issues that she's been having lately. She's been having some potty accidents, pee accidents inside the house. And even just yesterday, I gave her a bath. And as she was waiting for the treat, she peed on the floor, like, right as she was waiting. Like, it's almost like if she gets excited or something like that, she's wetting on the floor and stuff. So I told him kind of about that. I told him that she's been drinking a little bit more water. And I forgot what other questions he asked. But he asked a lot of questions. But he ended up giving her x-rays. And then he showed me her x-ray and said that her heart is a little bit enlarged. It's a little bit too big. And yeah, and he also showed that she has a little bit of arthritis on her back spine, like above her back legs. That might explain why some days she's limping and stuff, and then other days she's fine. So he gave us some amoxicillin, which is like antibiotics, I believe, for... he suspects that she might have a UTI, urinary tract infection, which would cause issues with, the bladder and all that. And then she's also, they also did blood tests. So they ran blood tests yesterday. I gotta call them now and see what they say. So, yesterday was a little bit of a crazy day and wasn't expecting that from her. Just wanted to take her in to get her nails trimmed and get some eye drops for her, and got kind of all this thrown at me, but explains a lot of things that she's having problems with, so.
Talk to you.
Okay, thank you.
Hello, this is Dr. Beatty.
Hello, hi, doctor. How are you?
Thank you, sir. Good, good. Okay, how's Sophie doing?
She's doing okay. No more potty accidents since, we started her on the antibiotics like that. She seems to be okay. She's taking the pills all right. She's only taken 2 so far. Yeah, so she's okay. Just curious what the results were from the blood test.
Okay, the blood work is looking on the blood test. Let us start with the liver enzymes. Out of four liver enzymes, two liver enzymes are pretty high. One liver enzyme is called ALK phosphate. Normal range is 5 to 131. It is 1,925. And the other one is GGT. Normal range is 1 to 12. We are having a figure of 24.
Wow. Okay.
So it is pretty high. So it means there is something going on in the liver. That is one thing.
Okay.
But the electrolytes, like kidney enzymes, are normal.
Okay.
Pancreatic enzymes are normal. Thyroid levels are normal. Complete blood cell count is normal. Now, okay. When the ALK phosphate is so high, and there are two conditions there. I told you that I think that the liver seems to be enlarged yesterday.
Yes.
And either you can get the ultrasound done.
Okay.
See, GGT, when the GGT goes high, it means that there is some hepatobiliary disease. So there can be sludging of the bile or something.
Okay.
ALK phosphate high means that there can be Cushing's disease. Now, if there are a lot of urine accidents in the house, I will recommend that you should get the urine analysis done.
Okay.
On the urine analysis, we should do a urine cortisol creatinine ratio.
Okay.
And if that ratio is above that cutoff point, then we should do the ACTH stimulation test, which will help us diagnose the Cushing's disease. And if we do the ultrasound, that costs you $375.
Okay.
But the ultrasound will check the condition of bile in the liver. It will tell us about the adrenal glands, all the internal structures.
Okay. Let me ask you this. What is the disease name again? I can't. It's hard for me to hear you. Cushing?
Cushing's disease.
Okay. How do you spell that?
Cushing.
Got it. Okay. Cushing. Okay.
Cushing disease. It's when their dogs, they have Cushing disease, they drink tons of water, can have urine accidents.
Got it. Okay. Okay.
But when the GGT is high, it means that there is some hepatobiliary condition.
Okay.
This is the disease of the bile ducts in which the bile sludges and the inflammation of the bile ducts can happen.
Okay. Would that explain like her stomach being distended or kind of like a...
Yeah.
Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, cool. So probably what do you recommend we do? Finish the antibiotics first and then kind of see how that goes. Does any of that tell you if she might have a urinary tract infection or would is that not indicative of that? Okay.
No.
Okay. So what do you think though? Finish the antibiotics and then maybe bring her in to do the urinalysis. How much does that cost?
A urine analysis will cost you... See, urine analysis 39, and we have to add on that test that is called urine cortisol creatinine ratio.
Okay.
And that test is about $40. Total will be 79.
Okay.
But it should be morning free sample. Morning sample.
Morning samples.
Morning test sample.
Okay.
Okay. When you leash walk the dog and take the sample, bring the urine here.
How do you? This might sound weird, but how do you go about collecting samples like that?
You have to take the leash, go on the leash, and then take a ladle or some flat saucer, and whenever he is doing the urine, collect the urine in that small saucer.
Oh, kind of. Okay. Yeah.
And then transfer into one of the bottles of the medicine in which we dispense it to you. You can clean that bottle of.
Okay.
The medicine with the soap and water dried and put it in that and bring it here.
Got it. Okay. Okay. Sounds good.
Okay.
Okay. I'm going to finish this round of antibiotics for the next week and then kind of just see how she's doing with that. And then we'll try to figure out when we can get in for that urine analysis. So thank you, doctor.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Okay. Have a great day.
You too.
All right. Thank bye. You. Just drove past the car wash that I wanted to go to, and it's a complete, absolute zoo. They have cars stacked too deep there. I don't know. We might have to go Monday morning or something like that. I don't know. It's a lot of stuff going on. Okay, so I don't know. I'm hoping that the antibiotics clear up, like a UTI that she could potentially have, but I don't know. It almost sounds like that this is a an issue that she that's causing that problem. Basically, it's not a UTI. It's this other issue with her liver. I'm going to have to do some research on this Cushing disease and see what that's all about and the symptoms and stuff and kind of see if that's what it appears that she might have, you know, based on her, how she is daily and her symptoms and everything else. And then we'll kind of go from there. But, yeah, just not really happy about all this. So just want my baby to be okay. But she is getting old, man. She's 12. She's going to be turning 13 this year. So she was born the day before Grant's mom and I got married. That's it. Let me go get some gas, so stay tuned for more. Bubbles! Alright guys, so this is the end of an era, and it's a little bittersweet. So what I'm doing here is pulling out all my parts that I have for the Audi. Guy's gonna be here in about 10 minutes or so, and yeah, I don't know. I really like that Audi, man. I just wasn't easy to work on. Wasn't necessarily fun to work on. Cool technology and stuff, but here's all my Stage 3 parts. And I got trans fluid, coil packs. I mean, there's probably some spark plugs in there. I have tools, just all kinds of stuff, man. So, giving this all away to this guy, and he can take it. All right, we are off on our first biking adventure. Got the truck loaded up, and Grant is going in Nikki's car. This is a big step for her. It's kind of exciting. So, we'll see how it goes. And I ordered a bike rack for the back of my Hyundai for this car here. I need a bike rack, so I ordered a 3-bike bike rack. That should be what we need. And it's like $50 or something, not even. And it'll be way easier and a lot less hassle than loading it into this truck here like this every time. And it's Grand Central Station out here. All right, all right.
Slow down. Slow down. You're gonna make me slow down, and then I'm not gonna be able to do it. Uh-oh. See ya.
Yeah. Yeah, don't get too close to her, okay? There you go. You guys are cute. Making me hungry.
Woo, not me. There we go again.
All right, guys. That is it. Ooh, the lens is fogging up. But we are headed home. You guys can see the sun is setting. It's getting dark. And we made it around twice. Didn't even do 2 full laps. And I went around 1 extra time as fast as I could. It's hard. It's, what is it, 33 degrees out. It's hard to breathe when you're rolling fast with the cold air. But nice day out. Sun was out. Still cold. Grant ended up finding a little kid to play with him at the park and stuff, so that was kind of fun. And yeah, I don't know. So we're just kind of having a good time here. So we're headed back home. We're gonna start probably baking or cooking dinner. Gonna make pork chops. Trying to think what else we got. I don't know, whatever else we can find or scrape together. But it was nice. It was nice. So I ordered a bike rack for the back of my car, and I can't wait. Like, this piling the bikes in the back of the truck here, it takes up the whole back, and it still just, like, hurts my back to get it into the truck and stuff. So it'll be nice to have a better solution for that. I'm just, like, now starting to defrost. My nose is running. Everything is just, like, meh. But, yeah, it's a good day. That's it. Stay tuned for more.